will discuss the topic of democracy, in which I will discuss about features, merits and demerits of democracy. This is the topic from class 9th. Okay, so first of all I would like to discuss about features. So first of all, free and fair elections are conducted. Free and fair elections are conducted in democracy. Okay, then second, every citizen must give one vote and that values, and that value will also be one. Then decision making power vests with the help of the representative. Decision making power vests with the representatives elected by the people. Decision making power vests with the representatives elected by the people. Okay, and last is what, fourth feature of democracy is what, in democratic government the party is bounded, or the government which rules the country is bounded by the limits, rules and regulations of our constitution. So fourth feature will be what, in democratic government they are bound by the limits of our constitution. These are the four main features of democracy. Okay, free and fair elections are conducted means, yesterday only I told that in democracy, in previous video I have told that free and fair elections are conducted means everybody are considered equal. Universal adult franchise, the representatives are given vote and the elections are conducted free and fair. Second feature is what, whatever the citizen is, whatever the post of the candidate is, either he may be CM of the state, governor of the state, PM, any political leader, but the vote given by that particular member must have the value of one vote only. Okay, and then each and every candidate has been given right to vote. Then what, third is what, decision making vest with the representative elected by the people means all the rules, regulations, plans, policies which are made, who will make, the people who have elected the government will make all the policies, plans and they will guide us. Okay, and then last feature is what, the representatives, or in a democratic government the government is bound by the limits of our constitution, means they are free to take any kind of decision, at the same time they are also bounded by the rules and regulations made by our constitution. They have to definitely work under the guidance and rules and regulation given by our constitution. Okay, now we'll discuss about the merits of democracy. Now first of all, we can say that democracy, why democracy is a better form of government. So democracy is a better form of government because it is more accountable. It is more accountable form of government. It is more accountable form of government. Okay. Second is what? It increases the quality of decision making. It increases increases decision making. It increases decision making process. Third, we can say that it enhances the dignity of the citizens. It enhances the dignity of the citizens. Then it fourth point now we will discuss ki in a democratic form of government the main merit is what ki here the our own mistakes can be sort out or it gives chance to correct their own mistakes. Okay, and fifth one is what? Ki it has been given majority. It has been given majority to take decisions. By the representatives elected. Citizen of our country. So these are the five features of our democracy. It is more accountable form of government. Okay, here the government made the policies and everything, but the government is 100% have to satisfy the people of our country. So we can say that it is accountable form of government. Means the government has to satisfy all the questions which are asked by the citizen of our country. It increases decision making power. Is also increased. Then dignity of the citizen is increased. How we can increase the dignity of the citizen? Ki each citizen have given equal rights, equal opportunities, equal status is given according to our fundamental rights, according to our constitution. So we can say that the dignity of the citizens can be increased. Then their own mistakes. If the government make some mistakes in their policies, then they are given the one or two chance to solve or to sort out their own mistakes. Okay, and last is what? It has been given majority to take the decisions. Means decision making power is given to the representatives of the government, which the people who has elected those representative by giving votes or by the process of election, they give them the chance to govern our country, or we can say to rule our country. So these are the merits of democracy. Now we'll discuss about demerits of democracy. First of all, is what? It leads to the delay. Means the decision power are delayed in democratic form of government. The decisions are not given immediately. So we can say this is the great drawback of our democratic form of government. Then there is no scope for morality. Why we can say there is no scope for morality? Because the political parties to win the elections, they didn't follow the policy of moral values. Rather, they do the unmoral things without sometimes knowingly also they do, and sometimes unknowingly also they process with the unmoral values. So we can say that this is the great drawback also. Second, that there is no scope for morality in democratic form of government. then it leads to instability. How we can say that it leads to instability? Because the government parties usually changes. The ruling party changes. The political leaders used to change, and so we can say that in democracy there is the feeling of instability. So it leads to instability. Then it leads to bad decisions also. This is the next feature of democracy, demerits of democracy, that it leads to the bad decision. How we can say bad decision? Sometimes the people, what they do, ki they, if they are having their political leaders of their own relatives, or they are associated with their neighborhood, or we can say they are associated with their family, then what they do, they bound with their decision that ki we must give them the vote to win the election. Either the opposition party have more good values than their relatives, but then also here it hinders their decision making power due to the relations or their friend relations or neighborhood relations. Their decision making power is lack. So we can say that this is also the demerit of democracy. Now this is the great corruption, we can say, everywhere. When the election process is going on, then in our practical life we can see that political parties are more associated with corruption, and this also leads the great demerit of democracy. Then last is what, the people sometimes are not aware, they are not aware about the political system of our country due to illiteracy, due to uneducation. They didn't know ki what is the process of election. So due to the lack knowledge of election process, here the people of the country didn't know how to process the formation or the formation process of election. So sometimes in our country the persons are too much illiterate also. The ladies and women don't know how to process the or function the election process. So there is, we can say, ignorance, and they didn't know how to participate in the election process. So this also leads to the demerits of democracy. Now these are the three points which I have discussed in this video: features, merits and demerits. Now you like, subscribe my channel. If you have any comments, then you can give me in my comment box. Definitely students, I will solve your problems. Thank you.